Right, love is one of those things that definitely one is always looking forward to getting. And of course, once they get into love, it's a beautiful feeling. For those of you who have not been in love before, well, all I can say is sit down, be humble. Your time is just around the corner. And that gets us into another love letter this morning. This one writes to us and says, hello, Aben. I really need your advice, please. I've been in a relationship for 1 year and 3 months. I like the way people keep count of their relationship. But anyway, he goes ahead to say that it has been an off and on relationship simply because my boyfriend always accuses me of cheating on him with my best friend. A thing that always annoys me because I have never cheated on him. Even when I get a chance of cheating on him. Hey, okay. However, what surprised me yesterday is that my boyfriend's best friend called me saying that my boyfriend was so sick and was at his place. I rushed to go and see him, and on reaching there, his best friend locked the door, tried to force himself on me. The whole story of my boyfriend being sick was a lie. When his best friend started forcing himself on me, I later gave him and we had sex. Now I feel so guilty and ashamed of myself. I can't face my boyfriend because I don't think I am for him anymore. Should I talk to him about it? Quit the relationship? Guilt is killing me inside. Please help me out.
Dun, da, da, dun. Da, 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 da.
I hope it's not the runaway thing.
Because first of all,
I think what this girl should do, because
she has to say something.
Yeah, she has to. She has to come.
Because I mean, this is falsely. This was someone luring you. This is actually rape. She should not just talk
to the boyfriend.
She should actually take it to the courts of law. Now, of course, for her, she's going to say, no, he was trying to force himself on me, and I just gave in, and we had sex. Baby girl, baby boo, honey boo pair, it is not your fault. Don't even for a minute guilt trip yourself. It is not your fault. You were caught in a situation that you couldn't be out of in a nif. And at the end of the day, I do understand if you're faced with a situation like that, other than suffer bruising and all these things, and you'd rather calm down at that particular moment. So, number one, you need to tell your boyfriend what exactly happened, because I'm going to see him beat up somebody. That's going to be beautiful to witness. And then you also have to report the case. At the end of the day, you need to understand you didn't bring this upon yourself. Someone falsely called you and they're like, hey, this is happening, this is happening. Gwali mutego. It was actually premeditated. So
I gotta just
Sula mumbugaza stani wati.
The devil's bedroom.
You know? So at the end of the day, baby girl, you have nothing wrong. You cannot begin to tell yourself, because you're not even telling the world or telling your man. You're telling yourself that you feel you're not worthy. You are worthy and then some. In your eyes, you should not look at yourself like you're not pure. And on top of that, I think she actually needs to go see a therapist, because she's dealing with the type of trauma that actually messes you up in the mind. Go talk to someone. Let this off your chest. And if he still wants you back, he will be with you.
Definitely.
If he does want to understand what happened, he will be with you. And in a way, he'll notice how much more vulnerable you are. Now, of course, I know what you're getting scared of is you're going to say, how sure am I it was right?
Well, by the fact that someone forced themselves on her, then
no, your truth is your truth. No, touch again. Boyfriend, I just gamba and zemani na wambu ya kukubira na kugamba.
And that's where I want to come from, because end of the day,
and I don't think she did that.
No, not recording per se, but you can as well go to Airtel or MTN or, you know,
exactly.
Other,
no,
and you get the,
listen,
the whole thing.
The call will be there. The call will be there. Do you know the process it takes for you to go to a company like Airtel to actually give you those records?
It's very simple, as long as you have a police letter, because this is going to begin as a police case. So all you need to do is just head over to the police, and if you report it as rep, the police is going to help you get the recording.
Oh, really?
Yes. It's possible, and it's very easy. It's just that we never do these things.
Oh.
But it's very simple and easy.
You actually need to court someone.
The moment you report it to police, police is definitely going to write to court, to give you a letter. And once court gives you a letter,
they can open up the
call. You know, the call center. It's that simple.
It's the best way to find out the truth, because for me, I want to look at the origin of this entire story. I mean, how she found herself in this, at this guy's address, the reason behind it, your boyfriend is ill, because then again, whether it was actually him telling it was ill or it was, hey, honey, can you come over and spend some time with me?
Because initially... The boyfriend could think, y'all has been banging behind my back.
But by the way, let me tell you, whoever your name is, sweetheart, if your boyfriend doesn't even believe you for
walk,
a second...
Walk, run, move.
It's okay. It's
I right. have a brother who is looking for a good girl.
Leave Tina's brothers alone. What I'm saying is very simple. If you tell your boyfriend and they don't believe you and they give you this whole bullshit of, you know, okay, I wasn't supposed to say that. Just move on. The moment you get it off your chest, you're
she
going to feel
you.
Relieved. You're going to feel happy again.
Actually, she's
on.
Doing this for self.
Yes.
You're not doing it for your boyfriend. You're actually going to have to do it for yourself. At some point, you have to speak your truth. You have to come, sit him down, this and this happened. Whether you want to believe it or not, that is your truth. The only thing that sets us free as human beings is our truth. Not what the world has to say. It's our truth. Nganze.
What do you make of this situation?
So your truth is based on the fact that you were raped. You know, I always say that.
Your truth is your truth.
Women have inner strength. And when it comes to such moments of, say, rape, my goodness, you'll see the Hulk in them. Her giving in because, yeah, well, she was cornered and all those things. Again, yeah, how much truth is in that? But anyway, let's look at
a lot of truth.
Let's look at what the story is saying. She was, you know, she was trapped and she was defenseless. What's what this guy is in for is two things. One, a girl that seemingly cheated on her, or a girl, rather, a best friend who betrayed him in that regard.
Those are all two situations that we don't even need to deal with.
But moving forward, as far as she's concerned, like you mentioned, her coming out and saying the entire truth, but how do you start explaining the entire story and how you had sex as a result of rape to your boyfriend?
No.
Wait, to your boyfriend.
You're confusing it.
No, I'm not confusing it, because then it's her fearful of her status with him. That's the boyfriend. Because then what happened to her was not called for, she didn't expect it. It was a phone call.
So she was raped.
Exactly. So it's that bit of fear. She has to find a bridge between her fear and, you know, coming out and telling the truth. But for me, I think when it comes to her and what happened to her, it's a nightmare for a monster to be above you or whatever behind you and doing all these things to you. But as far as the boyfriend is concerned, how he's going to perceive that story or that news
is not our problem.
Now, I think it's just another problem, by
and
the way.
And it's not her problem
that
either.
That will predetermine whether he actually stays around with her or not.
It's okay. 9 billion, how many people
that's
are in
what I'm
that
saying.
World?
I mean, if he does not decide to stay with this chick or with this girl right here,
he's
then
lost.
That's his problem.
He's lost.
Because someone going through this kind of trauma and a whole mental disturbance and then bring it out to you as a boyfriend, that means they trust you, they can confront in you. But then the moment they tell you and then you decide to, you know, flip the script around and start asking questions. Like,
then you're
you
a deadbeat man.
But you know how
we're
men.
No, you're a man, no, you're a man who
Tina,
is that's
Tina, Tina,
man.
You know how we guys can be sometimes. We tend to take it on a whole different level. Honey, I'm late, sir. I was actually hanging out with my friend and like, okay, they're going to do summer. I did some stupid stuff with you. That is how we are in our minds.
No,
so
that's how you are.
It's your job. It's your job as a woman, yeah, to come and help me find a place in my head. Listen, you told me what you told me, yeah, but I have the right to say that wasn't rape. That was just you and him just banging on each other.
It's not my job to make you believe, because I don't make you believe on a daily. Do I? Do I make you believe that today when you step out of the house you're going to get $10 million? No, I don't. Well, it's your job to make yourself believe. And I'm going to take it back to the statement we always use on this show in this particular hour.
Right.
Your happiness. Your happiness should not be determined by another individual.
True that.
Your happiness is yours. So if I come to you and I'm like, hey, babe, check this out.
I go late.
This is what happened.
Forcefully.
No, I didn't get late. I was wrecked. I was raped and this is what happened.
Oh, Lord.
It is entirely up to him to want to believe it or not believe it.
Would you care what he believes or not? Would you care?
Definitely have an opportunity to call us. Yeah. All you need to do is get the number on your screen right there. 041-433-7872. When we go in for this short break and get back, the studio lines will be open for you to call in and let us know what should this lady or this young, beautiful woman do regarding her relationship.